Namaste. Welcome to plant breeding video series, and this video is about genotype into environmental interaction, and I am Miss Varsha Gaitonde. The first and foremost thing, let us see what is genotype. Genotype is part of the genetic makeup of a cell and therefore of an organism or individual, which determines a specific character or phenotype of that cell or organism or individual. Genotype is one of the three factors that determine phenotype, the other two being inherited epigenetic factors and non-inherited environmental factors. DNA mutations which are acquired rather than inherited, like cancer mutation, are not part of the individual's genotype. Hence, scientists and physicians sometimes talk that, for example, about the genotype of a particular cancer, that is the genotype of the disease, as distinct from the diseased. Environment is what is around something. It can be living or non-living. Includes physical, chemical and other natural forces. Living things live in their environment. They constantly interact with it and change in response to the condition in their environment. In the environment, there are interactions between animal, plant, soil, water and other living and non-living things. Based on these interactions, the environment is classified as micro and macro environment. Microenvironment. It is known as microhabitat, a very small specific area in a habitat distinguished from its immediate surroundings by factors such as the amount of incident light, degree of moisture and the range of temperatures. Environment of a single plant or organism as opposed to that of another growing at the same time in almost same places, microenvironment. Each member of a population is subjected to a specific environment of its own. Individual itself contributes to its environment by the way of maintaining a certain level of temperature and humidity around it. This microenvironment differs from one individual to another in a population and includes solar radiation, disease, pest incidence, and soil vector factors along with weather fluctuations. Second is macroenvironment. Environment associated with variables having large and easily recognizable effects is macroenvironment and may include differences over year, location, fertilizer level, planting date, irrigation schedule, etc. Macroenvironment can be reviewed as a collection of microenvironment whose individual's effects on organism are quite small. That's why the phenotype is divided into G plus E plus G into E. In other words, suppose we have a continuous environmental variable, two different genotypes, 1 and 2. Now the regression equation is given as, here in the equation is given. Coming to classification of environmental variation, Allard and Bradshaw in 1964 classified the environmental variation into predictable and unpredictable variations. First one is predictable component variation. This includes all the permanent attributes, features of the environment like climate, edaphic factors like soil type, day length or photoperiod, agronomic practices like planting date, plant density, water management, fertilization, etc. Unpredictable variation or components means all the uncontrollable factors. It includes fluctuations, mild or violent in weather, season, year, with respect to annual precipitation or rainfall, temperature, RH, etc., coupled with variant agronomic practices. Coming to G into E interaction. This interaction is happen when two different genotypes respond to environmental variation in different ways. A norm of reaction is a graph that shows the relationship between genes and environmental factors when phenotype difference are continued. They can help illustrate G into E interaction when the norms of reaction is not parallel, as shown here, there is a gene by environmental interaction that indicates that each genotype responds to environmental variants in different way. It is shown here genotype 1 and 2 are interacting in different environment. This norms the reaction shows lines that are not parallel, indicating gene by environmental interaction. Each genotype is responding to environmental variation in different ways. Gene-environment interaction are studied to gain a better understanding of various phenomena. In general epidemiology, gene-environment interactions are useful for understanding some diseases. Sometimes, sensitivity to environmental risk factors for a disease are inherited rather than disease itself being inherited. Individuals with different genotypes are affected differently by exposure to the same environmental factors, and thus gene-environmental interactions can result in different disease phenotypes. Example, sunlight exposure has a stronger influence on skin cancer in fair-skinned human than in individual with darker skin. Coming to types of gene-to-E interaction, there are three types. One is no interaction. Second is non-crossover or no rank changes but interaction. And the third kind is rank changes and intersecting. Interaction may be due to heterogeneity or genotypic variance across environment, or imperfect correlation of genotypic performance across environment. When we are planting two genotypes, they may go parallel or no interactions, means they act differently in different environment, or we can say if we are planting the same genotype in different environment, means the response will be same in different environment, then it will go parallel. If the response is somewhat different, means not adversely affected but somehow affected with some kind of environmental interaction, it will give second kind, where non-crossover kind of interaction happens. And in the third kind, it is poorly adapted, where genotype in A environment will give rich results and in B environment it will give somewhat different result. In plants, 7 genetically distinct yellow plants were collected and 3 cuttings taken from each plant. One cutting of each genotype was planted at low, medium and high elevations respectively. When the plants matured, no one genotype grew best at all altitudes, but at each altitude, the 7 genotypes fared differently. Example, one genotype grew the tallest at the medium elevation but attained only middling height at the other two elevations. The best growers at low and high elevation grew poorly at medium elevation. The medium altitude produced the worst overall results but still yielded on 1 tall and 2 medium tall samples. That means altitude has an effect on each genotype, but not to the same degree nor in the same way. This is the example or explanation to the three kind of previous interactions. Coming to adaptation. Adaptation has three related meanings. Firstly, it is the dynamic evolutionary process that fits a population of organisms to their environment, enhancing their evolution fitness. Secondly, it is a state reached by the population during that process. Thirdly, it's a phenotypic or adaptative trait with a functional role in each individual organism that is maintained and has been evolved by natural selection. It is the capacity of genotype to adjust themselves in a specific or particular environmental condition so as to reach a certain level of phenotypic expression. Types of adaptation, two types, morphological and physiological. Morphological includes growth habit, stalk strength, radial symmetry of rhizomes, etc. Whereas physiological adaptation is resistance to parasites, greater ability to compete for nutrients or to stand desiccation. Adaptability. It is an ability of genotype to produce a relatively narrow range of phenotypes in different environments. It is the result of genetic homeostasis, refers to buffering capacity of a genotype to environmental fluctuations. Organisms face succession of environmental challenges as they grow and show adaptive plasticity as traits develop in response to the imposed conditions. This gives them resilience of varying environments. Classification based on extent of adaptation. General genotypic adaptation, example are IR8 or Kalansona. This means the adaptability to a wider condition. Specific genotypic adaptation means genotype which is adapted to particular area, like floating rice. General phenotypic adaptability, where example is synthetics, which are phenotypically adapted to a large area. And specific phenotypic adaptation means composites which are limited to definite area. Coming to stability, it is the performance with respect to changing environmental factors over time within a given location. This means that a stable variety is less sensitive to the temporal or spatial temporal environment changes that may take place. Depending on the goal and on the character under consideration, two different concepts of stability exist, which are termed as the static concept of stability and as the dynamic concept of stability. Both concepts of stability are valuable, but their application depends on the trait considered. Models of stability analysis. There are four important models. First and foremost is Findlay and Wilkins, proposed in 1963. Second is Eberhardt and Russell's model, 1966. Perkins and Jinks model, 1968. And Freeman's and Perkins model, 1961. Among these four, Eberhardt's and Russell's model was mostly discussed and utilized in the field experiments, whereas Freeman's and Perkins model is most effective and efficient model, but moderately used because of its complications. Stingold and Salter were probably the first to calculate linear regression coefficient to characterize the specific response of genotype to varying climatic factors. This regression technique has been described and elaborated by Yates and Cochran in 1938, Findlay and Wilkins in 1963, Eberhardt and Russell's in 1966, and Perkins and Zinks in 1968. In addition to the coefficient of regression, derivation mean squares, that is S square DI, describe the contribution of genotype and the G into E interaction. This was described in Findlay and Wilkins model first time, and again it was used in Eberhardt and Russell's in 1966. Freeman in 1973 recommends that the significance test of regression coefficients should be based on individual error terms rather than on pooled deviations because of possible heterogeneity of deviation mean square. In an analysis of variance, the G into E interaction can be subdivided into a part due to heterogeneity of bi and a remainder due to pooled deviation from regression. Heterogeneity of bi does not reach significance. The usefulness of regression approach for interpretation of data is doubtful. Coming to multi-location trials. Effects of factor under study vary from location to location and from year to year to obtain the unbiased estimate. Interest is determining the effect of factors over time to investigate G into E interaction. Example, plant breeder grow advanced breeding selections at multiple locations to determine those with general or specific adaptability. Pathogenist is interested in tracking the development of disease in crop and record disease at different time intervals and different locations. Forage agronomist is interested in forage harvest at different stages of development over time. Why it is so? That is just to investigate relationship between genotype and different environmental changes. To identify genotypes which perform well over a wide range of environment, that is general adaptability. To identify the genotypes which perform well in particular environment, that is specific adaptability. The number of environments. Number of environments chosen for the experiment depends on availability of plant material, diversity of environmental conditions, magnitude of error variance and genetic variances in any one year or location, then availability of suitable cooperators and cost of each trial and time availability. Coming to the locations of environment, variability of environments throughout the target region, that is proximity to ridge base and availability of good cooperatives. Before analysis, we have to see the normality, homogeneity, additive and randomness. ANOVA, analysis of variance, which partitions the total variance into its components. For multiple environment or G into interaction, here the formula is given. Environment and replicate blocks are usually considered to the random effect, whereas genotypes are usually considered as fixed effect. Analysis of variance is given for different oversights, over seasons, over years, like that. Here a table is given for analysis of variance over sites. The components include sites, replication versus sites, then genotype, genotype into site, and replication error. ANOVA for over years, over sites, and other factors is given here. Like weather variables, eco-physiological variables are calculated. Then by calculating these two, estimating the statistical model, yield can be calculated. In variable or weather condition 2, again recalculation of weather variables and eco-physiological variables helps in predicting the estimated model for yield. This is how the optimal management and drought management condition, where the graphical represents gives the yield in different environmental conditions with different temperature or elevated conditions. Coming to the challenges of gene-to interaction. When the environmental effect is greater but is irrelevant to selection. Many statistical approaches consider all the phenotypic variations like means across environment, which may be misleading. Need analysis that will help to characterize G-into-E interaction. This is not merely a problem, it is also an opportunity. Specific adaptations can make the difference between a good variety and superb variety. Some environmental variations is predictable that can be attributed to specific or characteristic features of environment like soil type, soil fertility, plant density. Some variation is unpredictable like rainfall, temperature, humidity, etc. The strategies for coping with G-into-E interaction. The first is broad adaptation, where develop a variety that perform consistently well across the range of environment, that is high mean across environments. This is equivalent to selection for multiple traits, which may reduce the rate of progress from selection. That will not necessarily identify the best genotype for a specific environment. That means if we are going to achieve one, we have to sacrifice the another one. If specific adaptation is our goal, that is subdivide the environment into groups so that there is little G-into-E interaction within each group. Breed varieties that perform consistently well in each environment. For that we have to carry out multiple breeding programs, which means that we have fewer resources for each and hence reduced progress from selection. Evaluate a common set of breeding material across environment, but make specific recommendations for each environment. Different models of G into E interaction. This is very important when we are going with multi-environment or multi-seasonal trials. The first and very famous model is additive main effect and multiplicative interactive model, basically called ME model. The second is sites regression or GEE or SREG model. Third is linear bilinear mixed model. First is additive main effect and multiplicative interaction model. This is a method for analyzing G into E interaction to identify patterns of interaction and reduce the background noise. This combines conventional ANOVA with principal component analysis. The main analysis parts include making ANOVA and calculating principal component analysis by using different softwares. It may provide more reliable estimates of genotypic performance than the mean across sites. Biplots help to visualize relationship among genotypes and environments, show both main and interaction effects. It enables to identify target breeding environments and to choose representative testing sites in those environments. It enables to select varieties with good adaptation to target breeding environments. It can be used to identify key agronomic factors, disease, insect pest, and physiological traits that determine adaptation to environments. A type of fixed effect is linear binuclear model. This is a formula given for model for ears and sites for ME model. What breeders usually do in ME model? Here the G plus E and residual effects are calculated. Then PCA on residues to visualize the G into E interaction is calculated. It is an alternative is to only remove G, known as GGE. Example of ME biplot. ME plot will be consisting of four different poles. It is again divided into positive and negative poles. The genotypes will be subdivided or grouped into adapted to particular environments based on the season and the conditions which it is adapted. It is divided into principal component 1, component 2, like that. Coming to the interpretation of ME model. General interpretations. Here, genotypes that occur close to particular environment on principal component 2 versus 1 by plot show specific adaptation to those environment. Genotype that falls near the center of by plot may have broader adaptation. The number of PCAs, that is interaction principal component axis, are needed to adequately explain the pattern of data. The thumb rule is to discard higher order principal components until total significance SS, sum of square due to discarded PCS, are near to sum of square due to error. Usually it needs only first two principal component axes to adequately explain the data. This model is referred as ME2. Approach is most useful when G into location effects are more important than G into error effect. The second model is site regression model. Here fixed effect linear bilinear model that is similar to ME. The only environmental effects are removed from PCA here. Their genotypic effects were calculated, here environmental effects are removed. The bilinear term includes both the main effects of genotypes and G into E interaction. Here, it may be used for evaluate test environments. Steps. First, the recommended pre-treatment or transformation by scale the data by removing environmental main effects and adjust the scale by dividing by the phenotypic standard deviation at each site. Use the classification procedure to identify environments which show similar discrimination among the genotypes. Use an ordination procedure that is similar to ME except that which is used in transform model data. Means in ME model, data transformation is not done, whereas here it is a must process. Use by plots to show relationship between genotype and environment. The third is partial least square regression. This type of bilinear model that can utilize information about environmental factors like rainfall, temperature, soil type. This can accommodate additional genotypic data like disease reaction and molecular marker score. Analysis indicates which environment factors or genotypic traits can be used to predict the gene-to-e interaction for grain yield. Factorial regression. Here, a fixed effect linear model is factorial regression model. It can incorporate additional genotypic and environmental covariables into the model. Similar to stepwise multiple regression, where the additional variables are added to the model in sequence until sufficient variability due to G-to-E interaction can be explained. Factorial regression is easier to interpret than the previous one, but may give misleading results when there are correlations among the explanatory variables in the model. The last model is linear bilinear mixed model. This have become widely accepted for the analysis of G-to-E interaction. It lead to factor analytic form of genetic variance covariance for environment, which has a desirable statistic properties. When genotypes are random, the co-ancestral can be accommodated in the model. Assumptions for linear model, that is errors homogeneous, normal distribution of residues, and errors are independent. Generalized linear models that can be used when assumptions are not met are SAS, PROP, GenMod, and PROC, NL mixed. Non-parametric approaches like smoothing spline genotype analysis. Concluding G-to-E interaction, it is an active area of research. Need to synthesize information that performance data and stability analysis, understanding crop physiology, crop models, disease pest incidence, molecular genetics, and agroclimatology, along with global information system. Thank you. I hope you liked my video and kindly subscribe to get the further updates.